Hey everyone, how's it going? This is Ash, and today folks, we're using the Budd RDC3 that is a diesel rail car in the Great Northern livery on the Maria's Pass, and we'll just be going on a short trip from Essex Station to Ronin Station in about 43 miles to go from here. As you can see, this is freeware, and it does look well made, and it is from a creator that does create payware add-ons as well, but it's a nice diesel rail car. Not sure what the horn is like, but quite nice as well, even if a wee bit basic. But let's just jump back in the cab. Let's have a look around. We do have the controls and the door does open, so that's nice. And just looking around in the engineer's compartment, but these are just the passenger doors, as it's just technically a rail car. And without further ado, let's get this thing started up and let's get started. See here folks, there's also a nice passenger view as well, which one is just out the window there and just facing forwards here. This is the Great Northern Railway version. Anyways, I'm going to return to the cab and I'm not going to go too fast as I don't want to miss Essex Station, as that will be our first pickup, although this will end automatically once we reach Ronin, which is 43 miles away. Just for the record folks, I'm not sure if there's any NPC trains on here or not, but I will have a look on the minimap whilst we're cruising along. Okay folks, slight change of plan. I just want to see what the top speed this can do, just to test the acceleration. What I'm going to do, I'm not going to go all the way to Groningen station, as to be honest, there is no NPC trains at all. So how do we look on the minimap, and as you can see on the screen just a moment ago, there is no NPC trains, and to be honest, just a fair train, and I didn't check fair train only, so I'm not sure why no NPC trains are showing on the Mirage Pass. But no, honestly, this is quite a nice little rail car. I think these date from the 1950s, I'm not entirely sure, but it'll be interesting to see how fast we can get this thing to go. And then once we get it up to a decent speed, we will cut this let's play quite short, so this one won't be very long at all, probably around 15-20 minutes or something, I don't know. But anyways, I'm going to spend all day on it folks, as I do have other trains planned to cover in future let's plays. And to be honest, I don't want to make this video too dull, which is why I'm not really bothering too much with the going all the way to Groningen, but we still have a boat, otherwise we'll have 39 miles left to go. But anyways, we'll find somewhere to stop the train on dual track in a sensible area. But speed wise, we're doing nearly 75 miles an hour, so that's quite a nice decent speed for an old rail car such as this. Okay folks, that is the end of this let's play. I thought I'd show off this rail car, which I did forget that I had in the collection. It is freeware, and I think it's made by I can't think of the name off the top of my head, but I think it's under it's the same company that makes the some of the payware stuff and that, like the GP38s and that, but I can't think of the name off the top of my head, but it is freeware, and I will find the link by the time I post this video onto the channel. So if you want to download it yourself and have a go, it is a nice rail car in my opinion. It is well made. Anyway folks, that's all for now. Big thank you for watching. I'll catch you in the next one.